Okay, haven't talked about this in class yet. We talked about the big picture, but not the specific. We haven't done a problem like this, so we'll talk about it in class as well if we need to, but not to say that you can't do a little thinking on this here. Estimate the mean height of you of male students on your campus to measure SRS. You know from government data, the height of young men is normal with a standard deviation of 2.8 inches. Okay, so this is male height. Okay. How large of a sample must we take to reduce the standard deviation of the sample mean? Now remember, sample mean, that means mu sub x bar and sigma sub x bar, right? So we don't know n is the sample size. So if I take a sample size of 10, then sigma sub x bar would be 2.8 divided by the square root of 10. If I took a sample size of 30, it would be 2.8 over the square root of 30. Right? Now there's asking us, how large of a random sample must we take to make the sample mean 1/2 inch? In other words, 2.8 over the square root of n must be 0.5. Okay, so we've got to figure out what n is for that. Let's solve this for n. So I'm going to go ahead and do some algebra here. 0.5 times the square root of n. I multiplied both sides times the square root of n. And it's in the bottom, so they cancel there. And now I'm going to divide by 0.5. And I get 2.8 divided by 5.6. This is square root of n. And then square it. So I take this, I square both sides. 5.6 squared gives me 31.36. So if n equals 32, 2.8 over the square root of n will be less than 0.5. Right? Because the bigger n is, go up here, the smaller the fraction is, because n's in the bottom, in the denominator. Okay? So that's what we want to do. We want to go to the next higher number, because the bigger the denominator is, the smaller the whole fraction is, if you're dividing by a bigger number. Okay? There you go. Do the last one here, and look at 37. Numbers racket is well entrenched in illegal gambling in most large cities. One version works as follows. You choose one of 1,000 three-digit numbers and pay your local numbers runner $1 to enter your bet. Each day, one three-digit number is chosen at random and pays off $600. The mean payoff for the population of thousands of bets is mu equals 60. That's the average payoff. Okay. And Joe makes one bet for many years. Explain what the law of large numbers says about Joe's results if he keeps on betting. Okay. Law of large numbers. Okay. Well, first of all, the law of large numbers says, in the long run. Okay, well, what's his chance of winning, first of all? His chance of winning is 1 in 1,000, right? And so, in the long run, he's going to win 1 out of every 1,000 times he bets. So specifically for this problem, and we're going to learn this later, how do you calculate this concept of what's the mean payoff for the population. So for right now, we're just going to assume that this is the right answer, but we'll learn how to do that. The average payoff for the population is 60 cents. So in other words, sometimes you win, sometimes you lose, but on average for everybody, it's going to be 60 cents. Now, it might seem kind of good to start with, but you're paying $1 to pay. So if your payoff is 60 cents, or your what you're going to win is 60 cents, you're losing 40 cents every time. So in the long run, you're going to lose 40 cents every time. Okay, that makes sense? All right, so that's what's basically going to happen in a nutshell. We'll talk about this some more in class, but just to recap, you're going to lose a dollar virtually all of the time. You're going to win, on average, 1 out of 1,000. So you're going to win big, $600, but that's going to counteract that with the all the rest of the time that you lose. So think of it this way. Say out of 1,000 times, we'll just talk here, 1,000 bets. Say you win once. Okay, then you just won $600. But you really only won $599, but we'll just say 600. Of those 1,000 bets, you lost 999. Oops, let me write it like this. Lost 999. So you lost $999. So roughly 1,000. So you really lost, is that for roughly $400. This is really $599. So you really lost $400. Okay? So really, and if I divide that by 1,000 bets, because you played 1,000 times, that's really, 40 cents, 0.40 cents or dollars per game. So this is what you lost. You lost 40 cents per game. Payoff. I may have said you won 60 cents. The payoff is what the company or whoever it is that's doing this pays out 60 cents, but you actually lost 40 cents per game. So they won 60, they made 60 cents per game on average. So in the long run, you're basically losing 40 cents every time you play. Okay, there you have it.